every promise. Every word spoken.
I believe every word you say. I receive all your promises.
Oh my God.
I won't be moved by what I see. I'll keep my eyes on what you show me.
Bigger. Say bigger.
Bigger.
Now if you're not believing for nothing, just chill. But if you're believing for a promise from God, lift your hands and receive it. Come on, receive it.
I believe
every word
you say.
And I receive all your promises. Man,
I won't be moved by what I see.
I'll keep my eyes on. Every promise is
bigger.
I will stand
still and see
what
it will be.
Everyone, welcome to Antioch Virtual Church. I'm Maya Ali. Thank you for joining our worship service today. Don't forget to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel to receive news and notices across the ABC network. Share the link, send up stars and hearts too. Let your family and friends know that ABC is live across all our social media platforms. Our women's ministry will be hosting their In Touch Tailgate Women's Salad Fiesta on the grounds in front of the Gen Next Complex on Saturday, April 20th from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Dress comfortably and come on out for fellowship, food, and fun. You know how Pastor Jackson feels about our health. That's why we're having another health fair on Saturday, April 27th at 8 a.m. It's all free. All you have to do is scan the QR code and register. Free screenings, free discussions with Dr. Reynolds, free fitness and health sessions, free vaccines, and free raffle tickets for participation, which leads to free prizes and giveaways. Register today for upcoming health fair. Calling all 2024 graduates. Don't forget to register for our upcoming baccalaureate ceremony to be held on Sunday, June 9th during the 10 a.m. worship service. Registration deadline is Sunday, May 12th. And don't forget that all high school graduate applications are due by Thursday, May 16th. For more information, email Tiara Reed at antiochbaccalaureate@gmail.com. Starting today, April 14th, and every other Sunday after until May 19th, Aspire Preparatory Academy will be hosting an open house next door at the school, immediately following our 10 a.m. services. So don't forget to check it after service. Are you a teacher interested in becoming an impact teacher? Simply scan the QR code and complete the survey and we'll reach out to you and arrange a meeting. Contact Lashinda Moore at 786-457-7720 or lashinda.moore@gmail.com. Calling all women. Prayer breakfast tickets are on sale now. Mother's Day weekend begins on Saturday, May 11th at 9 a.m. in the Miami Lakes Hotel located at 6842 Main Street, Miami Lakes. So wear your spring attire. guest speaker will be none other than Pastor Sharon Riley of Agape Perfect in Praise and Worship Center in Orlando, Florida. Tickets are only $35 and can be purchased in the lobby after service, on Eventbrite, or at the church from Monday to Thursday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. You don't want to miss it. Now, you can start registering for Antioch's 15th annual golf tournament set for Friday, May 17th at the luxurious Jacaranda Golf Club. Shotgun is 8 a.m. Breakfast and lunch are included. Register today in the foyer. Now, don't forget, there are several ways for you to stay updated with everything happening around Antioch. Check out our app and Antioch Impact on Instagram, or you can text the word Antioch to 51555. Now, there's a word from the Lord for you today, but first, join us in worship in the dwelling place.
To the Lamb who was slain. the Lamb who was slain for our peace. Lord of Lords, hey, we cry. Hey, 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 we cry. Listen, said hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, you're worthy. Lord, you're worthy, so 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 worthy. Lord, you're faithful. My feet just got light, y'all. I'm sorry. But if you're anything like me, your testimony is, no matter how dark the situation is in your life, no matter how bad the trials and tribulation is, God will always find a way to get the glory. Come on and put those hands together.
He'll find a way,
still find a way. I need some tambourines, way. Somehow he'll find a way. Way. Somehow. You got it now.
He'll find a way.
I hear you, Pentecostal section. Come on.
Somehow.
He'll find.
He'll find a way. Way.
Yeah.
Somehow.
Let me hear you. Come on.
He'll find a way.
He'll find a way.
Come on, right before you take your seat, put those hands together. Give God the best praise that you can. Come on, if you know that he's worthy of all of the glory. Come on, don't fool me. If you know he's worthy of all of the glory, do me a favor. Tell someone, neighbor, even in this, God gets glory. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the very presence of the Lord. Certainly we honor God for my being here, and I thank and I praise God. He'll find a way. Yeah, find a way. Somehow, God is going to get glory. I'll try one more time. God is going to get some glory. He'll let you go through just to bring you out to get some glory. He'll let you get sick just to heal your body, just to get some glory. He'll let you go broke and then turn it around financially just to get some glory. He'll let you cry, then dry your tears just to get some. He'll let you get sick and then heal your body just to get some. Am I talking to anybody in this house that knows somehow God is going to get some glory? And says he's going to get it anyway. One more time. Can you just give it to him? Come on. Can you just give it to him? Come on. Just give it to him. He'll find a way. Find a way. Somehow. Put those hands together in this place. Certainly we give God praise and glory and honor in this place. And one of the things that gives God glory today are these candidates who've decided they want to be like him. I'll try it one more time. One of the ways that God is going to get glory today is through the submission and the consent of these candidates who want to be baptized. I get excited about this day because this is the best decision that you can make. This is the decision to be like Jesus Christ, the decision to want to identify with his death, with his burial, and subsequent resurrection. And that's what baptism is all about. Baptism is symbolic of the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. When you step into this liquid grave, if you will, and the preacher put his hands over your nose and your mouth, that's symbolic of death. And when we take you beneath the surface of the water, that's symbolic of burial. And when we bring you up from the water, that's symbolic of his resurrection. Jesus died. He was buried. But he got up on the third day, according to the scriptures. Anybody glad about it? I'll try one more time. Jesus died. He was buried. Oh, but he didn't stay there. The story was revised. Because on the third day morning, he rose with all power in his hand. And when you decide you want to be like Jesus Christ, that's what that means. Some of these candidates were baptized as a child and didn't know the significance and how important it was. They didn't know the meaning, and they wanted to be baptized again. Others are being baptized for the very first time. And so whether it is your first time being baptized, or whether you have come to a spiritual awakening and you're submitting to be baptized again today, I want you to know this is the best decision that you can make. Because what that really means, and I'm talking to the candidates now, because what that really means in the real sense, it means as long as you live, he'll be with you. And the moment you die, you'll be with him. That means you're covered. That means that, you know, you can walk through the valley that casts shadows of death, and you ain't have to fear no evil because you got somebody that's with you. Have I got one witness in the building that know what I'm talking about in this house? It's called eternal security. Eternal security. And I just feel like saying eternal security. It means that once you are saved, you are sealed until the day of redemption. That nothing can stop that. Nothing can sever that. Nothing can interfere with that. No work you've done, no sin you've committed, that once you are saved, you are sealed. Can you tap your neighbor's neighbor? I'm sealed. I'm sealed. I'm sealed. I'm sealed. And that gives me hope. That gives me encouragement. It helps me smile in the midst of adversity, knowing I have a relationship with Jesus Christ. And somebody right now, you need that kind of security. Death is certain. The Bible says life is but a vapor. You can be here today and gone today. You got to have a relationship with Jesus Christ. And before the preacher preach and before the praise team sing again, I want to give an invitation to somebody under the sound of my voice already that you say, Pastor Jackson, I want to be saved. I want to accept Christ as my personal Savior. And more importantly, I want to be baptized. I want to identify with his death. I want to identify with his burial. I want to identify with his resurrected life. If you're here right now, as these candidates, can y'all please stand? These candidates, please stand. And you can go to my left. Go with Deacon Merrick and Deacon Brown. Amen. And my left. But is there someone who's coming? Are you coming to be baptized? Can y'all help me give God praise? My God, I thought you were just coming to church late looking for a seat. Let me come down and talk to you. Hey, y'all kind of quiet. Y'all kind of quiet. First of all, let's start this. Let me start here. Wait a minute. What's your name?
Gwendolyn Chipman.
Hey, Gwendolyn. And why are you here, Gwendolyn?
I want to be baptized again. I was baptized as a child about in first grade.
About in first grade? You don't remember that. You don't remember that, Gwendolyn. You don't remember that. So you want to be baptized today. And you accept Christ as your personal Savior.
Yes, I do.
Amen. Gwendolyn, you can go right to my left. Come on, give God praise. Hey, beautiful. What is your name?
Sarica.
Sarica. Like Erica with a Z? Okay. Come here, Z. Why are you here, Zerica?
To get baptized.
You want to be baptized? You accept Christ as your personal Savior?
Absolutely.
Come on, Mike. Come on, give God praise. Go with Deacon Brown. Hey, y'all kind of quiet. Come on, somebody in this house. Can y'all help me give God praise in this house? Who's going to talk first? You going to talk first? What's your name?
Keon.
Keon, what's your name?
Kimori
and Keon. Keon, why are you here, Doc?
Because of God.
Because of God, you want to be baptized?
Yes, sir.
You accept Christ, your personal Savior?
Yes, sir.
You want to be baptized today?
Yes, sir.
You accept Christ, your personal Savior?
Yes, sir.
Come on, can you give God praise for these two young men? Let's turn so the church can see you. What is your name?
Jondalyn.
Jondalyn? Okay. Like Wondalyn with a J? Hey, Jondalyn. Why are you here today?
To get baptized and give my life to the Lord.
Oh. And you accept Christ as your personal Savior? Come on, Jondalyn. Go with Deacon Brown to my left. Amen. Amen. Is there another? Come on, y'all kind of quiet, church. Look at these young people. Want to be baptized and want to give their life to Christ. Is there another person? 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 I don't hear no tambourines. I don't hear no tambourines. Where are my Pentecostal? Come on. I don't hear no tambourines over there. Angel, tell us your name. Come on, what's your name? You accept Christ as your Savior? Yes. Yes?
Yes.
You want to be baptized? Yes?
Yes.
God's going to do something amazing in your life. I speak this over your life. All of your life, listen, all of your life, God has a plan for your life, and you've been searching for whatever God wants you to do. You've been searching and seeking him. And I want you to know, this is just the beginning, Angel. This is just the beginning. God is going to do something phenomenal in your life, but you have to surrender to him. Hear me.
hear me, baby daughter, hear me. Surrender to him. Tell God, Lord, whatever you want me to do, I'll do it. Whatever you want me to be, I'll be. And I promise, if you trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding, and all of your ways acknowledge him, angel, he'll direct your path. He'll show you who to trust. He'll show you what you're supposed to do in life. He'll tell you who you're supposed to be. Do you believe that today? Amen. Come on, give God praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah. Come on, give God praise in this house. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus is best thing. Jesus. That's ever happened. Jesus is. Are they ready? Are they ready? That's ever happened. Want you to know Jesus is. That's ever happened. Jesus is. Come on, y'all, help me. Hey, man. Ever happened. Jesus is. That ever happened to me. Get ready.
Take me to the water. Take me to the water.
According to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost,
I love Jesus. I love Jesus. I love Jesus. Oh, yes, I do.
And being obedient to the great head of the church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
He is my Savior. He is my
church. I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
None but
church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Take me to the water. Take me to the water. I said, take me to the water.
Being obedient to the great head of the church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
I love Jesus.
And being obedient to the great head of the church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
He is my Savior. He is my
Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Won't you take me to the water? Oh, to be baptized.
And being obedient to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
I love Jesus. I love Jesus.
And being obedient to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
None but Elijah, none but Elijah, none but Elijah shall see God.
Relax. And being obedient to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
I love Jesus. I love Jesus. I love Jesus. Oh, yes, I do.
And be obedient to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
He is my Savior. He is my Savior. He is my Savior. Oh, yes, He is.
And being obedient to the Great Head of the Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Won't you take me to the water? Won't you be baptized?
And being obedient to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
I love Jesus.
Okay. Okay.
I
And being obedient to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
None but
Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith. Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Take me to.
Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
He is my
to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Take me to.
Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
I love Jesus.
Obedient to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
He is my Savior.
To the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my sister, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Obedient
to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my brother, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Take me to.
To the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my brother, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
He is my
to the Great Heaven Church, I baptize you, my brother, according to your own faith, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost.
I love Jesus. Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Be
baptized. Good morning, church. My pleasure and privilege at this time to welcome all visitors. May all visitors please stand and remain standing until the welcome has been given. Let's give a hand for our visitors. On behalf of our pastor, Arthur Jackson III, and the First Family, we would like to welcome all our visitors to the dwelling place. By now, you know that we have come for nothing else but to praise the name of Jesus. We pray that at the end of this service, if you do not have a church home, at the appropriate time, you will give our pastor your hand and guard your hearts. Those of you viewing online can text the word visitor to 51555. All visitors remain standing until you have received the package, all first-time visitors. All other visitors may be seated at this time. Let's show our visitors some love. Love offering envelopes are available upon your request so that we can be a tangible blessing to our pastor and his family. Thank you.
Young people are serving today. Can you help me give God praise for them? Come on, they're doing a wonderful job. With announcements and leading us in praise and worship. Amen. I thank God for them. And so certainly I honor God for my being here, and I thank and I praise God today for each and every one of you, my Heavenly Father's children. Thank God for those of you who are watching online and had an opportunity to greet some of you, Sister Marilyn Huntley from Charlotte, North Carolina, Sherella Saunders, Atlanta, Emily from Tallahassee, Darrell Rowe from Indiana, Minnie Stafford in Georgia, Cheryl Holmes in Albany, and others around the country who are watching us today. Thank you so much for logging on. I pray that you'll be blessed by what you have already heard and what we will hear in the very near moments coming. Certainly we're honored to have you. If you ever get tired of visiting us, you're more than welcome to join and be a part of us. We would love to have you a part of our family. Anyhow, can you make our visitors feel special one more time? Amen. One more time. There's some beautiful ladies here from Delta Sigma Theta sorority. Can y'all please stand on my left? These beautiful ladies from the Miami Alumni Chapter. They're celebrating their 30th anniversary. Come on, let's celebrate. Their 30th anniversary. I'll make some noise. Sister Norwood, Sister Norwood, you want to come? Are you going to come and just greet us? Jerome, give her Sister Norwood and help her up, Dave. Amen. She's going to come, give a few words, greet us. Thank you so much for selecting Antioch to worship. We realize you have a choice of where you're going to go, and we thank God that you are here with us today. Come on, give me a hug. You also.
Good morning. Pastor Jackson, the Antioch Missionary Baptist family, and visitors. On behalf of my line sisters, the praying 59ers.
The praying 59ers.
We prayed all the time.
All right.
We were initiated into the Miami Alumni Chapter 30 years ago. And on behalf of my sisters, and also on behalf of your member, R. Sarar, and president of the Miami Alumni Chapter, Stephanie Still Nelson.
Yes.
We are so happy to worship with you today. We've been many times and we love worshiping here. We have some sisters that travel from Atlanta and other parts of Florida. And we have one probably watching online in Africa that could not make it with us today. But we're so grateful to be here, and we'd like to give this donation to the Aspire Preparatory Academy.
Amen. I think our student leader is here. So come on up, our principal. Come on up, Ms. Sharonda.
come on. You can make the presentation and you receive that. Medium, let's get this on camera. Let's catch that.
Thank you
so much for being with us. Thank you, ladies. Listen, we're going forward in our services today. Just a couple announcements that we have for you. I need you to mark your calendars. April the 27th, Saturday, April 27th. It's going to be a very, very important weekend for us. We are about being healthy. We want to have good spiritual health. We want to have good mental health. Somebody say amen. Good financial health. But we also want to have great physical health as well. And so this is a holistic ministry. So oftentimes you hear me, I'm talking about the various areas in which we can become healthy. Of course, we come to our Bible study in church on Sunday mornings and we get a good word because we want to be strong and healthy spiritually. And we have a team of financial advisors who are part of our church. And every quarter, we give financial literacy information, how to repair your credit and first-time home buyers and things of nature, because we want you to be in good health financially. We have mental health counselors. Dr. Lewis Hines, wave your hand, Dr. Hines. Amen. I wanted some of y'all to see him because some of y'all really need to come talk to Brother Hines. I want you to be in good health. I want you to be in good health mentally. But we also, Antioch here, listen to me, we promote good physical health. Every Sunday afternoon at 1 p.m., we are exercising together. We have a boot camp. We have an instructor. I think I saw Sister April here somewhere. I don't know if I see Sister April somewhere. I saw her walking around somewhere. Oh, there she is. Come on. Sister April and her team, they're leading us in exercises at 1 o'clock. And we have yoga, male and female, unisex yoga. We're doing that together at 2 o'clock. I think I saw, where is the men's warehouse model? Where is... I'm just joking. Brother Eric, please stand up. That's Brother Eric. It's our yoga instructor. Yeah, yoga instructor. And so at 2 o'clock every Sunday, we're stretching together. And so I invite you to come at 1 o'clock as we exercise together, at 2 o'clock as we do yoga together. And I mention all of this, church, because we have partnered with a phenomenal organization to promote great health. Every quarter, we're having some kind of special event, and the next event is going to be on the 27th. We partnered with CHP and the CEO of that organization, Dr. Dwight Reynolds. I thought I saw him somewhere. Dr. Reynolds, please stand up. His lovely wife, Christine, please stand up. Come and give some God praise for the Reynolds, Dr. Reynolds and his group. Amen. Thank you. We have partnered with them. We're going to be exercising in the morning. We're going to have thousands of dollars worth of prizes that we're giving away. Large screen televisions and ear pods and iPads and all that kind of stuff to incentivize you just to come out to get the information. It's going to be here on the 27th from 8 a.m. to 12 noon. I want you to be here. Dr. Reynolds and his team will be here. Dr. Rudy Moise and his team will be here. We're going to be exercising together. April Bell and her team, we're going to ask if Eric can be here to stretch us Saturday morning, April 27th. It's going to have food and refreshments. You don't want to miss this, church. I want us to be in good health. Amen, somebody. I want us to be in good shape. Heart disease, listen to me, and I'm almost done. Heart disease is running rampant, and it is adversely affecting people of color. Amen, somebody. Some of these diseases that we are suffering from, they are preventable. Listen, I want the record. Listen, I want the record to reflect that whenever the Lord called me home, I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm saved. Amen, somebody. Amen. I'm financially secure. Jaden is set. My documents are in order. My will, my estate, Attorney Shalon, that's in order. Amen. Whenever the Lord called me, I'm ready. But I want to be as healthy as possible. Amen, somebody. I want to be as healthy as possible. And so I'm asking you to please join me here. April the 27th from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. as we partner with Dr. Reynolds and the CHP group. I know it's going to be a great time together. Listen, we're moving our services. We're getting ready to pray, and we're praying for members of our church. Please hear me. Our prayer list, is long and exhaustive. I want you to hear me. We're praying for Brother Rodney Shipp, Nikki Austin Shipp, her mother-in-law. Rodney's mother transitioned a few days ago, and we're praying for Rodney. We're praying for Brother Tyrone. And Sister Olga, Olga's husband, Ernest, his father transitioned. We're praying for them. We're praying for Sister Stephanie White, her mother transitioned. The funeral is going to be on this coming Saturday at the Peaceful Zion Church at 10 a.m. Sister April Bell, her beloved sister, transitioned. And we're praying for Sister April. Praying for Brother Minister Love. I saw him somewhere. Minister Love. And we're praying for him. His sister, Pamela, transitioned this past week. And we're praying for you, Eddie. We've been praying for Xavier Smith Jr., asking the Lord to just move on his behalf. He's up and down in his health, and we're asking the Lord to keep him up and to keep him strong and healthy. Derek Williams, Carrie Howard, praying for Stacy Musgrove. Sister Stacy, we're praying for your son. He's here today. Amen. We're praying for continued health regarding his heart. Donna Pender, Pastor Pender, in your family. I saw Pastor Pender somewhere. We're praying for Donna Pender, Patricia Jones. We're praying that God would bless them and to heal them. And we're praying for, listen, the Lenoir family, Pastor A.D. Lenoir. Some of you saw it on the news. He was tragically murdered in his church. The funeral is going to be here next Sunday here at the Dwelling Place at 3 p.m. We're praying for the entire Westview Baptist Church, the church where he was the pastor. We're praying for his wife and the four children that they leave behind. This senseless crime, not in the street, not on the yard, but inside the church. We're praying for that family. And I thank God for Antioch and our leadership that will be hosting and providing comfort for that family. Listen, we're not going to come around the altar. Can you just touch someone's hand right where you are? Touch someone's hand right where you are. Sister Rhonda, very quickly, come pray for us. Very quickly, come pray for us. Touch someone's hand. Well, I believe in the power of touch. And the Bible says, where two or three are gathered, he'll be in the midst.
God, we bless and glorify you because we know that you are worthy of the honor. You are worthy of the praise, God. We're grateful, Father God, because we can call you Father. We're grateful because we can bring you our prayers, our petitions, our concerns. And we know that not only do you hear, Father God, but you're more than able to address them. And so we thank you for that, Father God. We pray that you would forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness, that our prayers and our petitions might go before your throne unhindered, Father God. And so we lift up those people in our sanctuary, those people who are listening, those people in our communities, Father God, and our families with heavy hearts because they're dealing with loss, Father God, whether that's the loss of a sibling, the loss of a mother-in-law, a brother, a father, a spouse, Father God, we pray for them, Father God, we plead and ask that you would give them your grace, your power, your strength, Father God. We pray for those that are needing healing in their bodies, Father God. We lift up Minister Xavier's son, Father God. We pray that you would just continue to heal his body, Father God, for we know that by your stripes we're healed, Father God. And so we pray for those that need healing in their body, whether it's from an accident, Father God, whether it's from cancer, whether it's from whatever illness it may be, Father God. We bring them to your throne of glory, Father God, and we pray that you would just touch them as only you can, as their creator, Father God. We lift up the Lenoir family, Father God, and preachers in South Florida in general, Father God, for our preachers are under attack this week, Father God, and so we just lift them up, Father God. We pray that you would comfort that family, Father God, that you would strengthen them, Father God, and that you would keep your hand of protection upon those that bring your word, Father God. And most of all, Father God, we lift up those in the seats, Father God, because we know that each and every one of us has concerns, whether it's financial concerns, whether it's mental health concerns, Father God, whether it's healing in our bodies or healing in our relationships, Father God, we bring them all to your throne of glory, Father God, and we lay them at your feet because we know that you can do nothing but fail. And so we stand upon your promises because we know that your promises are yes and amen, and we claim each and every one of those promises for us, Father God, as your children over our lives. For your glory, we pray. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Come on, give God praise. Come on, give God praise. Amen. As we pray, Pastor Keith Robinson and his family, Pastor Robinson, pastor in the southern area of our city, praying for Pastor Robinson. Pastor Nate Austin's mother transitioned. And we're praying for him. Thank you, church, for praying for me as well. Listen, we're getting ready now to worship the Lord for the very, very first time in this, our time of giving. We're getting ready to give God back his tithe and our offering. Repeat that with me. Shout, his tithe, our offering. I say it like that because the Bible declare that the tithe belonged to the Lord. The tenth of what the Lord has allowed us to accumulate, we give it back to him. And then on top of that, we give God an offering, a way of saying, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I appreciate you. My father, who was my pastor, he put it like this. He says, it's the tithe is the debt we owe, and the offering is the seed we sow. It's our way of saying, Lord, I thank you. Let a friend borrow some money. I'll call his name. Oh, I won't call his name, but let him borrow some. Matter of fact, let me just move on. Let me just move on. I'm just about to get in trouble. Listen, we're getting ready to worship the Lord in our giving. And there are several ways to give. And our media has displayed those who are giving electronically. There are ways you can give electronically. It's being displayed on the screen. And if you need an envelope, our ushers, our young people are serving today. They're coming down. And if you need an envelope, raise your hand. I remember about our usher ministry, our youth usher ministry. They're doing such a wonderful job. Can you help me encourage them? Amen. They're doing such a wonderful job. Amen. 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 I see your hand up there. They're coming. They're gonna make their way up. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Bro, you didn't want to walk all the way up there? You sent the young girl? Okay, I understand. I understand. That's wisdom, bro. Amen. You didn't live that long being a fool. You sent the young person up there. All right. You said she was closer? I love our church, boy, I tell you. If you need an envelope, raise your hand. Those watching online, I'm going to address you in a minute, but let's give back to the Lord today. If you have your envelopes in your hand, your phone, can you please stand? Please stand with us. Come on, all over the building, please stand with us. Stand with us if you can. Amen. You've been sitting for a moment. Come on, let's stand. Let the blood flow. Stretch those legs. Let's stand. Get your gifts in your right hand. Come on, wave before the Lord one time. Give the Lord a wave offering. There's a giver's pledge we like to recite before we give. Out loud it says, Lord, I know that I can give you an offering only after I've given you the tithe. My giving reflects my total dependency on you and my obedience to your word. Though this seed leaves my hand, I believe by faith it will never leave my life. I will trust you, O God, by honoring you in my living and in my giving. By faith, amen. They said the kids wasn't going over. Going over. Okay, over. Come on, let's walk around together. With us today on our online broadcast. I know that you've been blessed already via the singing and the praises from our young adult ministry. And guess what? The best is still yet to come because there's a word from the Lord. Listen, I want you to be encouraged today, regardless of what you may be facing, going through in life. The Bible says we know all things are working together for your good. That's the word today. It's working for your good. Again, thank you for being faithful and your giving. Your contributions to us puts us in position to have a greater impact on society. Listen, I'm going back into worship, but one more time, thank you for being with us. God bless you.
shall be added. Over and over and over. He keeps on. Over and over and over. He keeps on. He keeps on.
Feel me.
Feel my love.
There was some miscommunication. So can all of our young people please stand? Please stand. All of our young people, please stand. We are having youth church. It's my fault. I got miscommunication. So all of our young people, I apologize, parents. All of our young people, please stand. They're going next door. Come on. Come on. All of our young people, please stand. Come on. Please stand. All of our young people are going. Come on. That's it. Hey, baby. That's it. Come on. Come on. Let's encourage our kids. They're going next door to the youth church. Amen. It's a miscommunication. I apologize. Amen. Our kids are going next door. That's it. Look at all of our kids. They're going next door. Thank you. Amen. That's it. That's it. Amen. All of our kids. Look at this. All of our kids going next door. Come on, y'all. Hey, beautiful. Hey, girl. Gabby, Dave. Amen. Kids are going next door. That's it. Come on, they're still going. They're still going. Amen. Wow, wow. All of our young people going next door. What a blessing. What a blessing. What a blessing. One more time. What a blessing. What a blessing. What a blessing. Still got one more. Come on, give us some encouragement. Hey, baby. Some encouragement. Kids going next door to youth church. Amen. 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 God bless you so much. Have a video introduction and then our young adult choir. Praise team will bless us.
Introducing Reverend Claude Douglas Cheatham Jr., a native of Orlando, Florida, is the son of Reverend Claude D. Cheatham Sr., Andrea Wyatt Cheatham, and Dr. Sherry L. Mason. He holds a BA in Liberal Studies with a concentration in Religion and Philosophy from Bethune-Cookman University. He holds an MBA, Edward Waters University. Reverend Cheatham is married to his best friend, Alexis Michelle Cheatham, and is the proud father of two amazing boys, Zion John Eric and Claude III, affectionately known as Trey, and one beautiful girl, Cesariah Alexis Michelle. Reverend Cheatham is genuinely a man dedicated to leading others to holistic victory and is committed to fulfilling that assignment with the spirit of excellence that God requires. Antioch, show your love and welcome to the pulpit in the dwelling place. The next preaching voice you will hear will be Reverend Claude D. Cheatham Jr.
Good morning, church. Today I'll be reading Romans 10, verses 1 through 13. Please stand as I read today's scripture. Brothers and sisters, my heart's desire and prayer to God for the Israelites is that they may be saved. For I can testify about them that they are zealous for God, but their zeal is not based on knowledge. Since they did not know the righteousness of God and sought to establish their own, they did not submit to God's righteousness. Christ is the culmination of the law, so that they may be righteousness for everyone who believes. Moses writes to this about righteousness, that it is by the law. The person who does not these things will live by them. But the righteousness that is by faith says, do not say in your heart, who will ascend into heaven? Or who will descend into the deep? But what does it say? The word is near you. It is in your mouth and in your heart. That is the message concerning faith that we'll proclaim. If you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. As scripture says, anyone who believes in him will never be put to shame. For there is no difference between Jew and Gentile. The same Lord is Lord of all, the richly blesses of all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of Lord will be saved. Thank you. You may be seated.
If you would just begin to slip your hands in the air and worship the Lord. Begin to speak well of him. Do I have any true worshipers in the house today? Hallelujah. Holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb. You are holy.
Come on, would you open your mouth and give God worship? Come on, all over this place. Come on, just begin to lift your hands. Open up your mouth. Come on, there's a spirit of worship in this place. Come on, God, we love you. We love you. We love you today. Come on, open your mouth. Come on, open your mouth. Come on, there's glory in this room. Come on, there's breakthrough in this room. Some of you came heavy. Some of you came in need of breakthrough. But by the power of God today, I said there's breakthrough in the room. Open up your mouth, dwelling place, and open your mouth like your life depends on it. Open your mouth because he's holy. Open your mouth because he's amazing. Open your mouth and give him the fruit of your lips. Come on, you made it. You pushed through it. Hey, hey. Worship in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have your way, oh God. 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 We came with problems, but we came to worship. We came with circumstances, but we come to worship. We bring you everything. We've come to worship. Hallelujah!
Worthy is the Lamb.
Hey, not the Oshai. Worthy is
the Lamb.
I know I gotta move, but I feel something in this room.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
Come on, come on, come on. Lift your hands, open your mouth.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Somebody just needed that worship right there. Glory to God. Glory to God. What you've been praying for, what you're in need of, it's in this room. Just lean over. Would you just put your hand, glory to God, in your neighbor's hand, all over this place. You don't know, you don't have to know their name, what they're dealing with, but just right now, all over this place, just begin to pray for them. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Just begin to open your mouth right now and just pray for the hand that you're holding. Glory, I feel breakthrough in this room. And the old side. Glory, glory, glory. Come on, come on, perform. Come on, come on. God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the hand that I'm holding. Whatever they came in this room carrying, whatever they came in this room dealing with, I declare by the power of the Holy Ghost for total breakthrough. I declare in Jesus' name, devil, you have no power. I declare that the blood of Jesus is against you. I declare that the heaviness, I declare that the hurt, I declare that that which we came in carrying, I declare in Jesus' name, devil, you're a defeated foe. You're a liar. You thought we were going to quit. You thought this was going to make us give up. You thought this was going to make us lose heart. You thought this was going to make us throw in the towel. But the devil is a liar. We push the church today and we declare there's breakthrough in this room. And so, Father, in the
the name of Jesus, I speak new all over my neighbor. I speak breakthrough over my neighbor. I speak a next level over my neighbor. I declare they will not quit. I declare they shall be encouraged. So I squeeze hope into my neighbor's hand. Come on, squeeze that hand, squeeze that hand. I squeeze hope into the hand. I squeeze peace into the hand. I squeeze next level in the hand. I squeeze and push. Glory, glory, glory. Come on, just squeeze that hand. Oh. Come on, just squeeze that hand. In the name of Jesus, it's already done. It's already done. You've been carrying it, but now it's time to release it because it's already done. It's already done. In Jesus' name, open up your mouth and give him glory in this place. Open up your mouth and give him glory in this place. Give God a praise like it's already done. No, that was good. I said, give God praise like it's already done. I said, give God praise, Antioch, like it's already done. Like it's already fixed. Like it's already worked out. Like it's already turning in your favor. Like it's already working together for your good. Open up your mouth. Yeah. And give him praise. Yes, 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 yes. Go ahead and get out of your seat. Tell 2-3 people it's already done. Come on, tell them. Tell them it's already done. It's already done. Come on, tell them it's already done. 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 It's already done, it's already done. It's already done, it's already done. See, some of you waiting on the music, but you ought to have a memory. Your mind and your memory ought to be the music. And you ought to give God praise like it's already done. You ought to give God praise like it's already done. It's already done.
Shout unto God with the voice of triumph.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
God, I thank you now for preaching privilege. Now give us preaching power. Stand up in us as only you can. Hide me behind your cross, dear God, that your people not see me, but see you in me. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your power. Speak a word to your people. In Jesus' name, amen. Would you clap your hands and give God praise all over this place? While you're clapping, can we give God praise for your incredible pastor? Come on, can we give God praise and glory? I'm thankful for you, Pastor, and all that God has been able to do through you. Look to you as an example. And so we're thankful and grateful. Can we give God praise again? This leader. Can we sound the alarm for this incredible worship ministry and all of the young people and all of the Sunday serving ministries? Can we give God praise? We certainly thank God. All of the Sunday serving ministries, each and every one of you in your respective places, deacons, deaconess, mothers, we certainly honor and give God praise for you. Amen. I'm thankful and grateful for my amazing, beautiful, incredible wife that's with me today, Alexis Michelle. Can we give God praise? Baby, if you just wave so they know you're here. I'm thankful unto God for our children, and amen, it's good to be here. I want to call your attention, that is, to Luke chapter 5. Luke chapter 5 will commence verse 17. Luke chapter 5. Thank you, Lord, for your presence on today. Luke chapter 5, verse 17. When you have a shout, I've got the word. You'll find these words recorded. The Bible says, one day when Jesus was teaching, some of the Pharisees and teachers of the law were sitting there who had come from every town in Galilee and Judea and from Jerusalem. The power of the Lord was present for Jesus to heal the sick. Some men came carrying a paralyzed man on a bed. They tried to carry him into the house and put him in front of Jesus. Because of the crowd, however, they could not find no way to take him in. So they carried him up on the roof, made an opening in the tiles, put him down on the bed in the middle of the group in front of Jesus. Verse 20 declares, when Jesus saw how much faith they had, he said to the man, your sins are forgiven, my friend. The teachers of the law and the Pharisees began to say to themselves, who is this man who speaks such blasphemy? God is the only one who can forgive sins. And Jesus knew their thoughts and said to them, why do you think such things? Is easier to say your sins are forgiven or to say get up and walk? I will prove to you then that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. So he said to the paralyzed man, I tell you, get up. I tell you, get up. I tell you, get up, pick up your bed and go home. I want to preach with this thought in our minds with the time that we will share together. I need a miracle. Would you help me preach that by looking at your neighbor? Say, neighbor. Come on, you put your preacher voice on and tell neighbor, I need a miracle. Tell that neighbor on the other side of you and say, neighbor, I need a miracle. May take your seats in the very presence of our God. I need a miracle. Friends, one writer says, sometimes in our darkest moments, we find the greatest clarity. It's where we realize that the miracle we seek is often hidden within our own will to persevere. As I ponder on this passage, the position of the person in this passage, we too can say that we are situated in a season where we are in need of a miracle. Friends, when we look at our communities and how even how some have been captivated by disasters such as earthquakes or even disasters as hurricanes or wildfires or even the more famous recent world eclipse, scale of destruction immenses and resources for recovery is insufficient. A miraculous aid or unexpected rapid recovery could be deeply desired. You let the truth be told today, we can testify that we as a people have survived the Middle Passage, survived the slave trade, survived segregation and Jim Crow and literacy tests and institutionalized racism and blatant racism and even 45. And if you let the truth be told, a whole pandemic, we can testify that we are in need of a miracle. And maybe you came in this place looking for a miracle, but can I tell you that you are a miracle? I said maybe you came in this place looking for a miracle, but can I tell you that you are a miracle? Just tell your neighbor you are a miracle. Come on, tell them. You are a miracle. That in fact, when every expert said it was impossible and every statistic said that you would not make it, you would not be able to stand here today, you can testify that you are a miracle. That when the job market was barren and opportunities seemed distant as dreams and the phone rang and there was an offer right when you needed it the most, you can testify that you are a miracle. That when all around you faltered and the weight of the world bearing down on you and you stood strong, a beacon of resilience and courage, you are a miracle. That when you survived the devastating storm that tore through homes and hearts, yet you walked out without a scratch, you can testify. Come on, I wish I had about 2-3 people in this room that can testify that you are a miracle. That when you found that unexpected job, just as those that have lost hope to be able to secure your family in desperate times, you are a miracle. When deep in valley sorrows, you found a way to offer a comfort for others. When you were in pain and needed hope and it felt like you were doubting the presence of God, you can testify that you are a miracle. When out of nowhere an old friend reaches out to you just when you felt all alone to remind you that you're not alone, you can testify that you are a miracle. And maybe if you miss any part of this sermon, what I want you to know is that God specializes in turning messy moments into miracles. I said God specializes in turning messy moments into miracles. Is there anybody in this room today that can testify that you had some messy moments, that the month hasn't always been amazing for you? You've had some messy moments. You went through some stuff that you wouldn't wish on your worst enemy. You've had some messy moments. You've had some stuff go on in your life that made you want to quit, made you want to throw in the towel, made you want to give up, made you want to go somewhere else, get somebody else to do it. Is there anybody here that can testify that God specializes? I wish I had about 2-3 people in this room today that can testify that God specializes in turning messy moments into miracles. And in fact, I want to prophetically speak over your life that for the rest of the month that you will enter the month of miracles. Would you just tell your neighbor, enter the month of miracles? I want to declare over your life that you will hear congratulations before the month is over. I want to declare over your life that you will hear approved before the month runs out. I want to declare over your life that you got the job. I wish I had about 2-3 people with crazy faith that can testify that yes, I don't see it right now, but I'm believing that my miracle is on the way. That yes, I'm in a messy moment right now, but I'm believing my miracle is on the way. Would you just high five 2-3 people around you in your section and tell them you just entered the month of miracles? And if you are claiming it, if you are declaring it, if you are believing it, you ought to just open up your mouth and pull blessings down
believe that when praises go up, blessings come down. I wish I had about 2-3 people that can declare, this is my month of miracles. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care what it feels like. I know what the report says. I know what the bills say, but you just entered the month of miracles. Touch somebody and say, you entered the month of miracles. Here it is. We zoom to a pivotal and essential part of the ministry of Jesus, because we see, friends, that Jesus is in the midst of the master's miracles. We see that Luke records signs, miracles, and wonders. But before we jump into our text, I want to back you in to this thing so you understand that you serve a God of miracles, that what God has done for others, he can do for you. I said, what God has done for others, he can do for you. Can I take this from antiquity to modernity and run it back to antiquity so you would understand? Are you here with me today that in Luke chapter 4, we see, friends, we see the healing of Peter's mother-in-law. We see the healing of Peter's mother-in-law. We see the healing of the possessed man at Capernaum. We see the miracle of catching a fish. We see the healing of the leper. And all of these show us that we serve a God that specializes in turning messy moments into miracles. All of these moments were messy. All of these moments, one was dealing with a possessed person. And we serve a God that has the ability to take those moments that it seems as if the devil was running rampant and turn that thing into a miracle that will work in your favor. We serve a God that has the ability to heal every mother in this room. I want to encourage you that just like the Lord was able to heal Peter's mother-in-law, the Lord is able to heal you. I know for every woman in this room, you wanted to give up. You were either mama and daddy. You were overwhelmed or overworked and underpaid. The Lord told me to tell you, are you hearing me on today, that the Lord has a miracle with your name on it. I said the Lord has a miracle with your name on it. Just like those that were endeavoring to catch fish, and for every business owner, for every entrepreneur, for every worker, for everyone giving their best, that just like those that were trying to catch fish were dealing with drought, the Lord has the ability to turn your drought into overflow. Oh, tell your neighbor, overflow, overflow. Come on, tell that neighbor, overflow. Come on, tell that neighbor, overflow. We see the healing of the leper. God has the ability to clean you up all over again. Come on, I'm looking at 2-3 people today that can testify that you've not dotted every I, you've not crossed every T, you've not gone everywhere you should have gone, said everything you should have said, but you can testify that the Lord can clean you up. Come on, is there anybody here? And pick you up, turn you around, and place your feet on solid ground. The Lord can clean you up again. And I like this particular text because when we jump into it, we are introduced to the paralyzed man. Everybody shout, the paralyzed man. And notice, if you will, if friends, you've got to understand the placement of this paralyzed man. You got to understand that this paralyzed man, don't miss this, is identified, he's identified by his diagnosis, not by his destiny. All right, he is identified by his dilemma, not by his destiny. He is identified not by his name, but by his condition. Yes, he is identified not by his character, but by his condition. Have you ever been there before? Have you ever been there before? Well, life lights on you in such a way. Life be life. And is there anybody know what I'm talking about? Life be life in. And you can testify that sometimes because of the capacity of life, you will find yourself being identified not by your name, but by your condition, being identified by the things that you've gone through, by the things that you struggle with. And notice, if you will, that we don't know a timetable or a length of his condition, but we do know he was paralyzed. We don't know if it was a serious situation that resulted in his paralysis, or if it was a series of situations that resulted in his paralysis. All we know is that he is a paralyzed man. All we know is that whatever it is that he went through resulted in his paralysis. Maybe I can use speculative theology, or what things and saints would call my sanctified imagination. Could it be that he was not just physically paralyzed, but could it be that his worries and his woundedness made him feel worthless? Friends, maybe, just maybe, he was emotionally paralyzed. Have you ever been there before? Well, you're triggered by trauma. Have you ever been there before? And I'm not sure what caused this condition. All I know is that he's paralyzed. Don't miss this. And a part of his life that should be working is stuck. You'll get it. I said a part of his life that should be working is stuck. And there's two or three of us in this room today that can testify that you understand how it feels to be just like this man in this text. A part of you should be working, but it seems as if you're on pause. That one took all of it out of you. That one pushed you to your wits' end, and that which should be working well is stuck. Notice, if you will, Jesus shows us through this paralyzed man that you should not allow people to label you by your condition. Because if you let the truth be told today, we all have some form of a condition. We all have been through something. We all have gone through something. And you ought not allow folk, are you hearing with me today, to call you by what you've gone through. And we see through this text, are you hearing me today, that you ought not allow labels to limit you when God has already promised to lift you. I said you shouldn't allow labels to limit you. You shouldn't allow the condition to limit you. You should not allow who you are to limit you. Don't allow labels to limit you when God has already promised to lift you. Where is the promise, preacher? The promise is at the end of the story, because in verse 25, he gets what he needs from Jesus. Here's the shout: that though he started with a problem, he now is walking in purpose. And you ought to give God praise and glory that where you started from is not where you're in. Started from the bottom and now I'm here. Is there anybody in this place on today that can give God glory that yes, it looked bad at the beginning, but it gets better from here? Would you just tell that neighbor, it gets better from here. It gets better from here. Don't allow labels to limit you, because it gets better from here. Notice, if you will, friends, that yes, in fact, it gets better from here, and all things are working together for your good. And can I give you a few reasons how this man got his miracle, a few ways he got his miracle. How did this paralyzed man get his miracle? Number one, he got his miracle because his friends helped him. I said his friends helped him. Notice, if you will, when you look at verses 18 through 19, it is all you see through this text is men. All you see through this text, are you hearing me on today, is they. All you see through this text is not a singular situation, but this is a moment of plurality. All you see in this text is that there were some friends. Everybody shout friends. That helped him get to where he needed to be. And here is what is clear, that this man could not take himself, that he was on a bed. Everybody shout a bed. One translation says that he was on a sleeping mat. Another translation says that he's on a stretcher. And no matter which version of the Bible you have, the one thing that we find in common with this particular text is the fact that he could not take himself, but he needed some helping hands to help him get to where he needed to be. And here is what I like about this particular text, because it shows us that you need some friends that will help you and not harm you. You need some people in your space. Are you here with me today? That are ride or die. You need some folk in your space that will improve you and invest in you and not ignore you. You need some people in your life that will equip you and not empty you. You need some people in your life that will position you and not pacify you. You need some people in your life that will minister to you and not mess with you. And here is what's amazing and incredible about this text is that nowhere in this text do we see their names mentioned. Lord have mercy. I said nowhere do we see their names mentioned. And here's my prayer for you. God, give me some friends that don't need their name mentioned in my narrative. See, some of us can't get blessed because we're too busy looking for credit. God, send me some folk that are so clear and riding for me that they don't need their name called. All they know is all glory goes to God, and they were the ones to rock with me in a moment I couldn't rock with myself. So what I love about this text is that he needed some real friends. I said some real friends. And some of us in this season might need to assess our circle. We might need, are you hearing me today, to go through our Facebook, go through our Instagram. Are you hearing me today? Check TikTok and start unfollowing some folk, because some of the folk that you following ain't even following you. Lord have mercy. That was, I said some of the folk that are, let me give it to you like this. If you ever expect spiritual elevation, you got to watch your association, because some association only survives by manipulation, which is designed to bring about your own personal devastation. But today it's time for elimination. Rewind. If you ever expect spiritual elevation, you've got to watch your association, because some association only survives by manipulation, which is designed to bring about your own personal devastation. But today it's time for elimination. And your prayer in this season is, Lord, if they're not like, if I don't have no friends like these guys in the text, I don't need them. Somebody says it's time to eliminate them. Notice, if you will, these friends approach Peter's house where Jesus is reported to be. And it's jammed in tightly. And notice, if you will, that Jesus is at Peter's house. And these friends set up their friend to get help at a house party. I said help at a house party. Jesus is giving help at a house party. And here is what's absolutely incredible about this moment, is that you need some friends that are so committed to you that they understand that calling them, it shouldn't be the last call. That you need some folk that are so committed to you that they know how to push you to Jesus. I said you need some folk that will push you to Jesus. And notice, if you will, these friends begin to do something amazing. They begin to tear off the roof and lower their friend down to see Jesus. Can't you see this in this text? Can't you see this? They began to tear off the roof and lower their friend down before Jesus. And could it be that the divine intelligent designer of our existence instigates a moment where these friends, before, don't miss this, they lower him down, they had to elevate him over the complacency of his condition. And see, some of us are in the same place that we're in because we are complacent, and we need some friends that know how to encourage us and speak life into us and tell us we're going to make it. Tell us it's going to be all right. Tell us we can push through it. And you need some friends that are so committed to you that they know how to elevate you over the complacency of your condition. Not only friends, did his friends help him, but secondly, we see his forgiver healed him. It's in verse 20. The Bible says, and when he saw their faith. You still see that there? You got your Bible app open. You got your Bible open. Notice, if you will, it says, and when he saw their faith, he said, man, thy sins are forgiven. You need friends, but you also need faith. I said you need friends, but you also need faith. Faith. Let's engage what their faith produces. Notice, if you will, that this paralyzed man and his friends get in front of Jesus at this house party where he is jammed in tightly. And notice, Jesus sees this man has a condition, and he says, I see your faith, so I'm going to forgive your sins. And I was confused, Antioch, because this man is paralyzed. Why is Jesus saying, I'm going to forgive his sins? Jesus, are you saying the reason he's paralyzed is because of his sin nature? Are you implying in any way that sin is the only reason I'm in this state? Jesus, are you saying through this moment that sin is the only reason a portion of my life is not working? He said, no, you got to tell the people at Antioch. You got to tell them the power of faith. No, you got to tell them the power of faith. Somebody shout faith, faith, faith. Come on, all of this room, somebody shout faith. You know what faith is. Faith, are you hearing me? It is impossible to please God. You know what faith is. You know, and without faith, it is impossible to please God. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. I'm talking about total belief, trust, and allegiance to God. Somebody shout faith. He said, you got to tell the people at Antioch, you got to tell them that when it is that you have present faith, you give God the ability to meet your need before you even know you need it. Lord have mercy. I said that when you have present faith, you give God the ability to meet your need before you even know that you need it. That you will come to God saying, God, I need you to work this situation out. And because of your faith, he's working another situation out and taking care of this one. That because of your faith, you'll come to God saying, yes, I need my body healed, but he's also going to give you that unexpected scholarship. That you'll come to God saying, God, I need you to work this thing out, and God begins to work another thing out. That's why you gotta have faith in impossible situations, because you don't know what your faith is doing. I said, you don't know what your faith is doing, what your faith can produce. You don't know that your faith can do some amazing, incredible things. You don't know that your faith can move mountains. You don't know that your faith can get you the job and the house. You don't know that your faith can get your child into school and tuition paid. You don't know that your faith can get you approved for the loan. Are you hearing me on today? And get you what you desire. Somebody shout faith. Faith can do it. I like this because notice, if you will, that he got his miracle because of faith. And here is what I discovered. No matter out your way, that whenever you're being helped and whenever you're being healed, you'll always have some haters. Oh, don't play like that. Whenever you're being helped and whenever you're being healed, you'll always have some haters. Notice, if you will, listen, verse 21. He gets what he needs from Jesus. He's lowered down before Jesus, and the people that should be excited are the very people that are hating. The people, are you hearing me, that should be excited and should be encouraging are the ones that are hating. Don't that sound like some of our lives today? And notice, if you will, look at verse 21. The scribes and the Pharisees began to say, who can do such a thing? And how many people are looking at your life, looking at what you drive, looking at what you live, looking at the stuff that they think that you don't deserve, and say, how in the world can God do that for them? How in the world? I knew them when. I knew when their life was tore up from the flow up. I knew them when they didn't have it together. I knew them when they were paralyzed. But here it is. You got to tell every hater that's been following you, every hater that's been on your trail, every hater that's been hating on you, you got to tell them favor ain't fair. Come on, you gotta tell them favor ain't fair. You gotta tell them that there is a favor on my life. Would you just look at that neighbor and say, neighbor, come on, say, neighbor, there's a favor on my life. That because of my friends and because of my faith and because I met the forgiver, I have favor. Would you just tell that neighbor on the other side of you that there's favor all over you? That I know you got some foes, but there's favor all over you. I said there's favor all over you. I gotta get out of here. But notice, if you will, the thing I love about this text, yes, is that even though he had haters, even though he had haters, he had a family that was happy for him. That when you jump down to verse 25, the Bible shows us that his friends and his faith and his forgiveness and his favor gave him a future. The Bible says that he went to his own house and he began to show his family what the Lord had done for him. He began to show his family that he came bruised, but he left blessed. He came bound, but he left blessed. He came with a burden, but he left blessed. He came bothered, but he left blessed. And that's the power of evangelism. That's the power of you telling your story. That's the power of you telling what the Lord has done for you. You gotta tell your family what God has done for you. You gotta tell your family how the Lord picked you up, turned you around, placed your feet on solid ground, how the Lord made ways for you out of crazy situations. And this what this family did, they praised and gave God glory for what they seen. Their
in your life, but can you give the Lord glory for what the Lord has done in your neighbor's life? Would you just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't look like what I've been through. I've been through hell and back, and I survived. Is there anybody here that can testify I am a miracle? Is there anybody here that can testify you were looking for a miracle? And if you Google a miracle, my picture will come up. I am a walking, talking, moving, breathing, living miracle. Is there anybody in this room that'll get out of your seat and tell somebody, I am a miracle? You didn't know it when you sat next to me, but you set yourself up for a life-changing miracle. Can I tell you what the real miracle is? God bless you, Antioch. Thank you, well, but one Friday on a hill called Calvary, can I tell you the real miracle? They put nails in his hand. They put nails in his feet. They put a crown of thorns on his head. They thought it was over, but the real miracle was, he said, if I be lifted, I will draw all men unto me. Yeah, because early Sunday morning he got up with all power, and because he got up, you ought to get up and give him glory. Shout yes, shout yes, shout yes. So you owe God a praise, you owe God a hallelujah, you owe God a thank you, Jesus. You're a miracle. Get out of your seat and give somebody a high five and say, I'm a miracle, I'm a miracle, I'm a miracle. Shout yeah, shout yeah.
That's able to turn circumstances and situations around. I don't want you to, if you can give me a minute, I don't want you to miss the message of the text. Here is a brother that was in a mess because he was incapable of standing on his own two feet. Everywhere he went, he had to be carried. And this is a tragedy when folk got to carry you. It's a tragedy when your foundation is fractured to the point that you're unable to stand on your own two feet. The healing of this man was just not giving him his faculties back, but it was giving him freedom. It freed him from the dependency of others. Somebody need to understand that that's what the Lord want to do for you. He wants to free you from the dependency of others. That this man was paralyzed. He was paralyzed. Everywhere he went, somebody had to carry him. Everywhere he went, somebody had to take him. But God wants to empower you to do for yourself what others used to do for you. And that can only happen with a relationship with Jesus Christ. If this man never met Jesus, he would have been still carried. If he would have never had this encounter with the Lord, folk would have still been carrying. But oh, he met Jesus. And when he met Jesus, Jesus empowered him to do for himself what he needed others to do for him. And I don't know who needed to hear this word today. I don't know. But I'm talking to somebody under the sound of my voice. The Lord wants you to be empowered. Can you help me because you don't know who you're sitting beside or standing beside now? Can you tell your neighbor, he wants to empower you? He wants to empower you. He wants to empower you. Stop letting folk carry you. Come get connected to Christ. He'll empower you to stand and to walk and to do for you yourself what you've needed other people to do for you. But you got to believe him and you got to have a relationship with him. Is there one today under the sound of my voice who wants to be empowered? Is there one today that wants a connection with Christ? Is there someone today that understands the only way I'm going to get free is by coming to Christ? Come on, I see you coming. Get your stuff, get your keys, and meet me right here at this altar. Come on, I see a brother coming. I see a brother coming. I see a brother coming. I don't know what's in your bag, but I see a brother coming. Come on. Is there another? Is there another? Is there another? Come on. Is there another person? Come on. Is there another person? We prayed this morning that the Lord would send someone that needed to be saved. If you're here, would you trust them? Is you here? If you're here, would you trust them? Come, some sister, some husband, some wife, some young man. Will you trust them? They come from the back. Come from the balcony. God can turn some stuff around in your life. Will you trust them? Come on, would you trust them? Would you trust them? Would you trust them? Would you trust them? Last call, will you trust them? Will you trust them? Come, freedom is at this altar. Empowerment is at this altar. A second chance is at this altar. A turnaround is at this altar. A new start is at this altar. Deliverance is at this altar. Who am I talking to? Come get it. If I'm talking to you, meet me at the altar. Come, the doors of the church are open. Come, I'm waiting for, I know that you're here. Some young lady ought to trust him and meet me here at the altar. Come on, I see you coming. Come on, give God praise for her. Give God praise for her. Come on, give God praise. Here they come. Come on, here she comes. Can you act like it's your niece and your granddaughter coming? Can you act like it's your cousin? Y'all ain't happy. Y'all, I need a happy church. Here's a young lady coming down the aisle right now. Can you act like it's your niece, your daughter, your auntie coming? Come on, I need a happy church. I need someone that can get excited, that can get excited about what God is going to do. Come on, that's it, baby, that's it. Here they come, here they come. Here they come, get excited, get excited. Hallelujah. Here they come, here they come. That's what I'm talking about. You need a turnaround in your life. Turnaround is at the altar. Deliverance is at the altar. Come on, is there one? Is there another? 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 Come on. Come on. I'm waiting for you. Some young man ought to come. Someone said the other day, Pastor Jackson, I'm going to join your church when I get straight. I said, brother, in that case, you ain't going to never join because you can't get straight on your own. Amen. You need to come join and we'll help you straight. If you could get straight, you wouldn't need to come. Are y'all hearing me in this house? Amen. Come just as you. Come just as you are. Come on. I'm waiting for you. Come on, sir. Come on, sir. Come on, sir. Come on, sir. Come on. Come on. I'm waiting for you. Come on. There he is right there. Come on. Y'all ain't happy. Act like it's your grandson coming. Act like it's your nephew coming. Come on. There he is. It makes some noise. My friend. Come on. Is there another? 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 Listen, some young lady, you're waiting for your husband, your wife to come. Listen, listen, don't wait. Tomorrow is not promised. You come. Come now. Go home and tell him, listen, I joined the church. Amen. Don't wait for him. I'm not going to wait for you. I'm not going to wait for you. I'm coming. Jesus, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Amen. Some young man, don't wait for her. You come now. Be the leader of your family. Come now, come now, come now. Last call, come now. When I pray, it's too late. If you're coming, come on, bro. That's it. Don't wait for her. Look at her. Don't wait for her. If you come, then she'll come. You come first. Y'all ain't hearing me. You come first. Here he is. You come first. You come first. You come first. Go home and tell her, I got saved. I joined the church. What you gonna do? Come on. That's it. That's what I'm talking about. Give God. Here he is. Amen. Last call. Last call. Last call. Last call. Last call before we pray. Before we pray. Before we pray. Before we pray. Amen. All over this building. All over this building, I need you to extend your right hand to this altar to cover them. Those watching online, extend your hand to your computer screen or to your phone. God's going to deliver someone in this house. God, our Father, we love you today. I pray mightily for this altar. I thank you for these young men. I thank you for these young ladies. I pray for our children today. We cover them now. I pray that no weapon formed against them would prosper. Be with them and keep them now. Devil, you are a defeated foe. Take your hand off these, the children of God. I pray now, God, for new destinies, new direction. I pray for empowerment. I pray for turnaround. I pray for miracles, signs, and wonders to be released into their life. In Jesus' name, amen. Give God praise. Listen, I'm going to ask you to go to my right in a minute. And then we're going to go back there. And listen, there's some people here, and we want to get some information on you. Listen, we need the right number, your phone number, the real number. Give us the real number. Give us the real number. Give us the, listen, I'm not done. Look this way. Give us the real name. Don't give us your alias. Amen. Don't give us your club name. Amen. Look at you. Put your head down. What was your club name? You had a club name. Go ahead. What was it? Go ahead and tell me. Confess. What was it? Give us the real number. Give us the real name. Amen. We want to call you. We ain't going to be trying to holler at you. Nobody going to try to get with you. Amen. We'll get your real name, your real number, and we're going to, what's wrong? What's that? What's wrong? What's up? We good? What's up? I pray for you. Amen. Listen, I pray. That's what I do. What specifically? What you need the Lord to do for you? We want the whole church to pray. You just want me to pray. We want everybody to pray. That's a good answer. We want everybody to pray. Right? That's a good answer. Specifically, what do you want the Lord to do for you? Tell me.
I want him to change my life around.
I gotta come down. I gotta come down. I know you hear me. What's your name, bro?
Joshua.
Joshua. I mean, that's a great name, Joshua. Man, that's a good name. Walls are going to come down for you, bro. Somebody will catch that. Walls are going to come down for you, bro. Listen, Joshua, I want to tell you something. In the Bible, the preacher preached about miracles today, right? In the Bible, oftentimes when Jesus performed a miracle, people had to participate in the miracle. That when he raised Lazarus from the dead, somebody had to move the stone, right? When Joshua walked around, the walls were knocked down around Jericho, Joshua had to walk around the walls. When Jesus turned water to wine, somebody had to fill up the water pots. When Jesus healed a man with a withered hand, he had to stretch it out. What I'm saying, Joshua, is God can do his part, but you got to do your part. You see what I'm saying? God can change your life. He's going to give you the power to change your life. But there's some stuff, Joshua, that you got to do. That God will give you strength, but you may have to change your associations and change who you hang with and change your thinking and change some of your habits. And God's going to do his part. But if you really want to change, if you really want your life to be different, Joshua, there's some stuff that you got to do. The first point in this man's sermon today was he had friends. This man was paralyzed, but he knew people that knew Jesus Christ. He didn't get to Christ on his own. He was connected to somebody, and the people he was connected to brought him to Jesus. In fact, the Bible says when Jesus saw their faith, are you with me today? So Joshua, there's some things, bro, that you got to do yourself. Are you committed to do those things? Well, guess what, church? He's committed. So I need everybody to extend your right hand and come on to Joshua. And today, call his name. Call his name. Joshua. God, I pray for Joshua now. This whole church pray for him. We pray for a change. We pray for a deliverance. But just don't change him physically. Change him mentally. Change him spiritually. Change him socially. Change him financially. Change his walk, his talk. Change the way he think, oh God. I pray that when he leaves this church today, everything about Yeshua, Joshua, will be changed. In the name of Jesus Christ, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet, we believe it by faith. And the church said amen. Come on, give God praise. Y'all go to my right. Come on, give God praise in this house. Come on, remain standing, remain standing. Come on, go right to my right. Come on, right to my right, baby. Come right to my right. Go right to my right. Go right to my right. What's in your bag, bro? Is it right? Y'all check. Amen. You walk right by security. All that's left in this bag. Lord have mercy. Just stood right in front of me. Walk right by security. Just stood right in front of me. Yeah. Stuff in this bag. Ain't nobody stop him. They ain't check him. They ain't frisk him. You see, when I get my monitor, when I get my gun, my metal detectors, we're going to shut all that down. Come on, give God praise. Come on, remain standing. Stand. Listen, I'm going to pray and I'm going to get a benediction and the seniors will be dismissed first. I'm going to pray, get a benediction and the seniors will go out first. Ladies of DST, y'all 30 years, thank you all so much for being with us today. God, we love you. Thank you for your word. Dismiss us from this place while never dismissing us from your presence. I ask in Jesus' name, and now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus, the risen Christ, love of God, the sweet communion of this Holy Spirit, may rest, rule, and abide with us now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. Stand still. Seniors, come on, seniors, be dismissed. Come on, all of our seniors. Are you a senior?
Thank you for watching the ABC Network. We hope that you were blessed by the worship and word today. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and download our app to stay connected with everything happening around Antioch. And remember, we're doing greater works with greater intentionality. May God continue to bless you and keep you. Until then.